Barre, Vermont is known as the granite capital of the world. In 1888, the Barre Railroad was organized to serve roughly 30 quarries located on Millstone Hill, near what is known today as Graniteville. Although Barre's granite quarries are a mere shadow of what they once were, the original Barre Railroad lives on, as the Montpelier and Barre Division of Vermont Rail System's Washington County Railroad. It's August 23rd, 2023, and I'm in Barre, Vermont to spend a day on the Granite Line. The crew is just going on duty, with VTR Jeeps 211 and 208 taking over for flood-damaged 804 and 2147. After readying their power and getting their work orders, the crew heads up the hill, light power. I watched the train cross Quarry Road twice, as they gain elevation rapidly due to a ridiculously steep 8.9% grade, as well as a switchback. We will return to the switchback later, but right now we're moving onwards towards the runaround at the top of the hill. Near the old Bombardier plant, the crew stops to fuel their power. Major flooding in July caused extreme damage to the Granite Line. Washouts, debris on the tracks, damaged locomotives and freight cars, and unstable roadbed caused the railroad to halt operations for a few weeks. Vermont Rail System, working with the state and R.J. Corman, had the railroad up and running in under a month, and getting the backlog of granite loaded and moved down to Montpelier was the main priority by the time I visited in August. At 500 gallons, the fuel was shut off and the crew continued to Websterville. The first task of the day would be pulling empty gons out of the switchback storage track at the very top of the hill. After running around the empties, the crew heads up to the loading area to wait for 7 cars to be loaded.
Thank you.
The quarry had only just begun the process, which meant a lengthy wait time for both me and the crew.
So only one of seven cars was loaded, so I'm like, well, if they don't know what they're doing, I'm going to McDonald's while I can. So that's exactly what I did.
Eventually, the seven loads were complete, and the crew pulled them down to the runaround.
Thank you.
While the crew spotted the empties, I safely got into position at the switchback near Quarry Hill Road. This is where grades reach 8.9%, and clearing the switch required two attempts.
Go ahead and try another run. Yeah, try it again.
Now it's time for a traditional chase of the loaded granite train from Barre to Montpelier Junction, unfortunately limited by heavy traffic and construction delays.
See the flood, some of the flood damage. This, like, this was flooded. This was all flooded. Like, it's just, it's insane what happened here. You can see trees down. I can't imagine what it was like.
You don't have to imagine, thanks to Island Line Rail Productions. And as you can see, the flooding caused major damage to both the railroad and the car dealership. Both have been put back into order by the time of my visit, but it will be a while before Barre is completely back on its feet. The crew has picked up 7 more loads at the Barre runaround and is continuing to Montpelier Junction.
Bye.
At Montpelier Junction, the crew drops their train on the north leg of the Y before using the south leg to run around their train. Although the crew still had to run back to Barrie, I was exhausted after 3 long days of traveling and rail fanning, so I called it a day and headed for home. This formally concludes Trains Vermont, The Trip. Check out other episodes, and I'll see you next time.